Welcome back to Chem Help ASAP. Now let's talk about how atom size affects charge stability. So we have four different acid-base reactions on the screen. We start with HF at the top and then work down to HCl, HBr, and HI. Note that these follow a vertical periodic trend. And what happens as you go down the periodic table? You go down the periodic table, atoms get bigger. And so we're looking at this charge correlation. Now, what happens to the pKa of these acids? Well, HF has a pKa of about 3. HCl is minus 7. HBr is minus 9. And then HI is minus 10. So we go from weak to strong in this trend as we go down the periodic table. And this gets into the size of the atom. Fluorine, chlorine, bromine, and iodine getting bigger. Now, when you look at these acids, there's nothing in the acid form to really tell us that it's more acidic. What we need to focus on is the conjugate base. So, fluoride is small. It's very compact. It has a very, in essence, a dense negative charge. So, it is it's less stable. Less stable makes it more reactive. More reactive how? Well, more reactive as a base. It's more basic. So if you notice, this ends up, the fluoride is a pretty strong base, at least relative to this series. And if it's a strong base, that means the corresponding acid is weaker. As you move down the periodic table, chloride gets a little bit bigger, bromide bigger still, iodide is the biggest, therefore iodide is the most stable, which means it's less reactive, how? Well, it's less basic. This is a base, so it's less basic. Once we say this is less basic, well, that means the corresponding acid that gave rise to that base is a stronger acid. So this is how, in general, we use this idea of charge stability. In this case, we're looking at a size trend in the atom that bears the charge, how we use this trend in stability of the anion to talk about and learn about the relative acidity of this series of compounds. This is our first example of working through how different properties affect charge stability.